Good afternoon, Workato fans, and welcome back to fabulous Las Vegas, Nevada. We're here barreling through day two of our live coverage of World of Workato. My name is Savannah Peterson. Really pumped up for this next chat. This is the most excited I think I've seen you before one of these, Rob.
I thought this was one of the best parts of the keynote yesterday, and I was very excited to have her on today. So we could dive into that.
Yes, I can tell, Rob. It's great. Without further ado, the lovely woman that Rob was talking about, Gaby, thank you so much for taking time to hang out with us.
Oh, thank you for inviting me. Super excited.
You are having quite a week. All the stages for you. Probably a lot of really amazing customer conversations. What's it like for you to be able to connect with your community in person here in Vegas?
This year is special. We've been doing this for a few years. It's always fun to see customers in person. But I think for me this year, it's really unique because we've spent all this time using our technology in this new way for ourselves, for our customers, within customer success. And to come and show that off and show not just, hey, this is what our product can do or this is what it can do for you, very important, but this is how it's helping us help you and connect at that most like more authentic level has been so fun. And then I've had customers come up to me, honestly, individuals from customer success teams that we don't always interact with and say, that clicks, like, this is my job too. Let's chat, let's connect. Beyond the technology, it's just been really amazing.
I can imagine. Y'all have done a great job. I just got to give you and your team a shout out. Y'all have done a fantastic job curating the customers that we've had up here and the stories that we've gotten to hear. Everyone loves you. Your people love you.
We love our customers too.
Yeah.
We really do. The customer success team at Workato is absolutely spectacular. And actually, there's a lot of kind of back and forth. We have people that go and work at our customers, and we're very happy to welcome some of our customers who want to transition over. And I think that kind of just That's community fun. Element yeah. is really real and really great. And also, our customers are just like very innovative. I think they're looking for a company, and that's kind of there's like that match of we're looking for a partner, we're looking for somebody to be creative with, we're looking for somebody to be strategic with, and that yeah. just makes the day to day like so much fun.
You can really tell. I mean, people will blow air about culture all the time, but y'all really walk the walk. And one of the things that I thought was really cool is when I've asked all your customers why they chose you or why they love working with you. Yes, they talk about the technology and the solution, but it comes after they've talked about how wonderful the people are, which is really special. It seems like you're definitely one of those companies who's innovating with folks as we launch this enormous new rocket that's coming up. How often are you engaging with customers like during your daily work day?
Oh, every day.
Yeah.
Every single day. Yes. And that's all the way up to VJ. And all the way down to, you know, the newest customer success manager. But, you know, even the way in which we actually metric ourselves and what did we accomplish this quarter, we track every time that we interact with a customer and what we're talking about using our own software. But we're talking in terms of, you know, how often did we talk to somebody about architecture? How mm-hmm. often are we talking about to somebody about goal setting? How often are we trying to explain how a feature fit their strategic plan? And so really, like, ideally, and this is where I think even Agentic can help us push this envelope, ideally, we're talking to customers as many hours of the day as possible. And then all the other stuff, hopefully the machines can help us accomplish more and more of that. Yeah.
Yeah, that's where I was going to go off of the keynote and all of that was, and again, having very briefly sat in your shoes at a company and for a software vendor. It's just the toil that goes into because you want to help that customer, especially with AI and how you're getting them set up and you're helping them overcome challenges. How do you see AI helping you internally, and then how are you helping those customers actually get to their agentic rollout?
Yeah, no, that's a great question. And I think 2 years ago, honestly, there was a lot of fear. I was somewhat afraid, right? What does it mean to have Agentic come into our lives? What does it mean for a function like
Super
customer
rare.
Success,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
I mean, as a leader, some of the obvious initial questions that come, we heard a little bit about like augmentation versus replacement and what are all the so what's of that? But I think, and BJ referenced this a little bit in our keynote, that as we started to really use that our own product to make agents for ourselves, it became very obvious that this is really about complementing even the best person to just show up in the best version of themselves every single time. And just how much this technology can still be 100% about relationship building. Mm-hmm. And it's just about bringing that A game, the thing that you can do if you're perfectly rested and you had time to prepare and you've had a great day already and you just had that moment of inspiration from talking to another customer that had the same problem. Like, we all have those moments where like all the stars align and you're like, yes, this is the top of my game. Right. I'm in my groove. But that doesn't happen all the time.
Right.
And that's what this technology can enable, right? It makes all these connections for us, and then it can serve them up to us in a way that we can take that in, then take a deep breath, remember where we're here, which is that human connection, and then show up and do our jobs, but just in a much, much better way than we had before. So it's been a huge transformation even for me, going from that place of just like question marks, right? What does this really mean? To one where I'm like, wow, no, like, This core relationship building, it's sticking around. And now it's just, how do we make each and every moment special using this new agentic technology?
What was it like for you personally as you started using Genies internally?
At first, it was a little bit chaotic. I think we've referenced this a little bit, and I'm sure as you talk to some of the people on the floor, it's not a like, I turn it on and it just worked right away. We had a lot of exciting ideas, so that was one element of it. A lot of ideas we had to sift through. Where do we really start? We eventually anchored on this idea of start with the KPIs, right? Like, what are the things that we want to move the needle on our business? Mm-hmm. And then start to focus the ideas by aiming at the KPIs. So that was like a big kind of experiential change from just like, so many things we could do to like, okay, what are we really going to do?
The focus is actually very impressive within your organization. And I think it helps you stand out and differentiate, quite honestly, in a market where everyone wants to use the same acronyms.
Absolutely. And it's a guide for the customer too, 100%. Right? It's not just about how you do the technology. It's just actually how you run your business. Stay focused on the KPI. Stay focused on where you want to move the needle. And then apply this in that context. And that focus really has made all the difference. Yeah.
And I guess as you do that, because you are, you know, kind of, hey, I'm stuck on this. How do I do this? You're interacting with the customers to help them be successful with their Genie deployments and things. How often are you using the experience that you've had and, you know, documenting that and helping those customers say, hey, here's how you work backwards from your KPI and here's kind of the process. Things to think about. Oh yeah, by the way, here's some resources that were a partner. How often is that?
Yeah, so we have something called the Gears framework,
yep.
Which is basically exactly what you're describing, right? Like all of the how-tos of how you do automation, integration, and now agentic, not just the technology piece, but the change management of it all.
Mm-hmm.
And we've updated that to be agentic, but I actually want to give a shout out because we were not the first to come up with this stuff. It was really our customers. Our first inspiration for getting started with agentic came from our customers. Our customers had the most advanced agentic deployments a year ago, not ourselves. Like, we were busy building the product in partnership with them.
Mm-hmm.
And then we kind of said, okay, now we got to really walk the walk as well. But I mean, you have several of them here today. I'm sure some of them have come in to speak with you, but they led the way and we partner with them. But, you know, they're some of the most incredible, innovative companies I've ever gotten a chance to work with. And in this, like in really almost all of our other developments, they've been with us every step of the way. And we've learned a ton from them.
I think that's really compelling. And I love that they were the catalyst there. Talk about listening to community needs in that aspect. But you're telling me, I mean, this process really only started a year ago?
Uh-huh.
You've done a lot.
Mm-hmm.
In the last year.
Yes. I joke because I took a 1 week vacation in July and I was joking with people. I feel like I came back and I'm like, I'm sorry, where do I work? What is happening? So much is changing so quickly and it's super exciting. It can be a little disorienting at times too, but this is what our customers are going through as well. And so there's really no choice for us. Like, we have to plow ahead at the speed and the pace that they're setting so that we can even be there to help and partner with them. Yeah.
So what have you been hearing as you walked around, as you're in meetings, here at WOW this week? What are you hearing from the customers?
a lot of excitement. I think, you know, 2 years ago, it was the like, wow, what could this be? What could this technology do? Last year, it all kind of crystallized into like, okay, agentic agents. But there was a big question mark on like, how do you apply it? And now this time around, we have multiple customers and ourselves that have been actually applying this and having people use it day to day. So there's a lot of excitement that now there is a blueprint. And, you know, how fast can we go over the next year in helping people who are still in that ideation or kind of how do I do this phase get to now I am doing it. Now I am in the process of that learning cycle, but by using agentic in my business and moving the needle there. I think the other piece too is some of these developer tools have been really exciting because a lot of the customers that we work with are working with that CIO organization and they have developers all over the business that are super excited and really creative when it comes to agentic and AI. And now with Workato, they're able to bring all of those constituents in a safe, secure, governable way. So they've been really, really excited to just partner with some of the most creative people in their org, but in a way that, you know, they can go from prototype to like actual enterprise grade solutions a lot faster.
And you're empowering developers and engineers of a variety of different backgrounds and levels of experience, which I think is, if I hear one more technology executive say that we're democratizing AI when it's the same 12 dudes who's made all the billions last time, like it's not that.
Yes.
It's what you were doing. And yes. And it's the ability. I mean, as I was sitting there, I don't code, and I was watching your demo yesterday, and I was like, wait, I can do that.
Yeah.
I can build this.
Yeah.
This isn't overwhelming. And I think I really can't wait to see what else you're able to unlock. Ooh, I got a question for you. I got a couple questions for you here. So what's been the most surprising thing in your journey as you've worked with your customers on their agentic future?
Oh, I think the most surprising thing is your data does not have to be as perfect as you think it does.
Interesting.
Yeah, like I think we all kind of had this assumption that, okay, the AI will be better the more clean, perfect data that you have. And so the first step is like, go back and clean your CRM or go, and like everyone's eyes are going to be like, oh my God, impossible. Like no way are we going to have perfect data before we start. But I think what we've learned is actually how crisp you are about the problem you're trying to solve. And the more focused that you can make every one agent, they're really smart. Like they can fill in a lot of those gaps. And as you're giving it feedback and testing, you just don't need as like perfect of data as you think you do. And so again, like take your KPI, build the prompts and just start. And you'll see what the real gaps are pretty quick and you fill those in. And we're talking like a day, you see the issue, you fill in a little bit of data, you test again, and you can sense, oh, it is already getting better. You can keep going. So the development cycle is just really, really fast. But like, let me tell you, our data is still not clean. And we're doing so much with agentic. Like, you don't have to be perfect before you start.
That's I like that as a piece of advice, too, because you're right. I think there is a lot of over-indexing on, oh my gosh, and it's going to break this system. You know, once you sort of got, well, and obviously there are some things that can make it chaotic, but to your point, you can really start seeing those results. And more importantly, you can learn what you have to fix rather than having to spend all that time that might not be necessary at all. Mm-hmm. All right, I got a personal question for you. If you could design a genie for your personal life right now, what genie would you design?
Well, I have a young daughter. So it would probably be around meals that we can all eat.
Oh, I love that. What parent can't relate to that?
Indeed. Yeah. Indeed. You know, so that you feel like it's like we all love chicken tenders and mac and cheese. And if health was not a constraint, we'd have that every night at my house because I know we do all eat that. But adding nutrition as another constraint there, I would love to have a personal genie that's like, you know, what will a 2-year-old eat that adults should also be eating.
I absolutely love that. What's your daughter's name?
Gigi.
Gigi, you want to say hi to Gigi?
Hi, Gigi.
All right. That's a great one. Honestly, that genie would then also work for, you know, when we're on the road and we're all going out to dinner and everybody's got their preference or whatever that might be.
I was just talking to a customer that uses AI for this, but they cycle like pretty intensely. Yeah. And so they're doing like nutritional plans for their cycling days. And I was kind of inspired.
I know, it's fun. And it's great that we can all cross-pollinate. All right, well, one final question for you, because this has been a blast, Gaby. When we are hanging out here at WOW 2026, what do you hope to be able to say then that we can't yet say today?
Oh, that's a really good one. My hope is that we can talk not about getting started with AI. My hope is that almost all customers here have tried it.
Mm-hmm.
And really what we're talking about is the next level problems, especially when it comes to collaboration. I think that's a place where right now we're playing around. Like, yes, AI talking, you saw it in the demos, right? AI is talking to me, AI is talking to Maria. But what about when AI needs to coordinate the account team?
Mm-hmm.
What does that look like? And we're just kind of starting to play around with those experiences. And I think there's just sort of this like second order set of questions once we've proven out that that kind of basic interaction works. So yeah, my hope is that we've shifted the conversation from we're all going to try, we're starting to try, to now we're figuring out how to really collaborate through this.
Yeah. And that's when we'll be able to see a lot of the impact at an even greater scale.
Absolutely.
Well, Gaby, I really look forward to talking to you about that next year.
See you next year.
Yeah, it's going to be
great.
Thank
you both.
And thank you, Rob. Always a blast.
Always.
Always. And thank all of you for tuning in to our wonderful 2 days of live coverage here at World of Workato in Las Vegas, Nevada. My name is Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.